And it's amazing that that's not the only bit of the piece that he wrote. There's actually a fugue that follows, but we won't hear that today. But I'd like to move on to something that is not in the program that's going to give a contrast to what the Germans call the Sturm und Drang, fiery storms and all sorts of things to their music. And I'm going to switch gears, and I'm going to play a piece by an Austrian composer. I actually played it as a prelude to the Mass this morning. It is called Siciliano, and her name is Maria Theresia von Paradis. The next piece by César Franck is actually part of a set of three pieces. He called them chorals. Very interesting because they're a fine definition, an example of what is referred to as the French Romantic school of composition, and that is when the composers were just totally caught up in the beauty of their cathedrals in which they played, the beautiful art, the stained glass windows, the surrounding countryside, and what they did, they just created totally from their heart and soul. And they were just very freely and very dramatic, you know, and also very, in a very less of tender moments and things like that. You will hear all sorts of mood changes in this piece, and it actually begins, like the Bach Passacaglia, it begins with a very serious theme played in the feet. And then toward the middle of the piece, you're going to hear it switch gears. And when it switches gears, you're going to hear an absolutely beautiful very spiritual prayer. And that prayer is actually like referred to as part of the choral aspect of the piece. one of the greatest rewards that is mine to treasure week after week of serving the parishioners of Sacred Heart St. Francis de Sales Church and those who are visiting with us, those friends of ours, is the playing of hymns. To me, a hymn, when played well, is a very, very special, it's an art form unto itself. And I especially love to put my own spin on them. I thought that in conclusion, what we could do is we could sing a hymn. And today, our church celebrates the Feast of Christ the King. And I feel an appropriate hymn to honor the Lord is the great hymn of the faith, Crown Him with Many Crowns. Crown Him with Many Crowns is on the back cover of the program. So if you'd like to turn your program over to the back, and I'm going to play the hymn through once, and then when you hear me begin singing the first verse, please join in singing. Those who are able, shall we stand?
In the